I wanted to do something practical that is useful. And so science seems to be something that meets these two criteria. I sometimes think it's also fate. It sort of happened in the college where I went to with a scholarship. The teachers in science were very good, and I realized that if I just studied literature, which I was very interested in, I couldn't be practically useful to people. I think it's important to know what it is important for you in your life that you really want to accomplish and achieve. We wanted to have a point of care, robust, simple nucleic acid amplification platform or a machine that can be used anywhere by anyone. In fact, we tried it in Malawi in the villages, and we taught the village women to do it and then watch how they perform. They did perfectly well. We were able to achieve the kind of simplicity that's required to have a complicated nucleic acid-based test that can be performed anywhere by anyone with a minimum training. When you apply for IP, it makes everything so much more defined and concrete. So the process is a learning process in the first place. But of course, as all scientists in our group, we were very IP conscious. We knew that if we want to protect our business in many ways and protect our technology, we do need to know what is unique about it, what improvement we made, and how we can protect it from a business point of view. So I think we have always been very IP conscious, and I think it's a very important part of a scientist's journey. And actually, if you ever want to put into practice what you have invented, it is critical that that IP is filed at the right time by the right people with the right claims. In any endeavor, the perseverance is probably one of the most important things, that however difficult it is, you don't give up, you keep trying until you make it.